Hi, today we're going to be making the surround a bow, which is actually this bow that surrounds a bow over top such as this, using the Offray Bow Genius Bow Maker. Your bow maker should be set up in this configuration using the larger combs as well as the center needle attachment. What you'll need is a pre-knotted upholstery weight ribbon, once again with the loop at the end, an extra needle, a pair of scissors, and a clip, as well as your favorite 3/8 inch Offray ribbon. You'll need about 70 inches. And what we're going to do is we're going to puncture, and if you notice here, I'm using the top side down. I'm going to puncture the end in. And as you see here, these combs are in sections of 4. We're going to be using that as the gauge. All right, so what we're doing is we're going to wrap around the outside of each of the 4 combs. Coming back in, like I said, the top side is going on the bottom in a figure 8 motion. I'm doing it again to the opposite side, around the comb, puncturing it again, making sure constantly that your top side ribbon is on the outside. Going around the top comb, puncturing the back side, leaving the top of the ribbon facing down. Once again to the other side, so it's a kind of a figure 8 motion. So I've actually gone through all 4 combs, okay? And what we're gonna do now is make the smaller inside loop, which is this one in here, to add more dimension to it. We're going to go and count 3. 1, 2, 3 prongs. We're going to loop it around, puncture bottom side again. Doing the same on this side. 1, 2, 3, wrapping it through, puncturing it again. Going this side, far right, counting the combs again, the prongs, 1, 2, 3, looping it back over, puncturing it again. Always remember that you have to leave the top side of the ribbon on the bottom. Going around this side as well, counting 1, 2, 3 prongs again, and looping over, and puncturing again. I'm going to cut my excess off. I've allowed for that on the 70 inches. And this is what it looks like before you insert your thread. So I'm going to insert my thread, leaving 4 to 5 inches out, and I'm going to go in through the center loop here, grab all my loops, pulling straight up. Okay, pulling the excess out. Okay, and I'm gonna take my little clip, hold on to it for positioning. Take another needle. Feed my thread through. Take off my clip. And what's great about the Bow Genius is you already have your first stitch in. So all we're doing is a top side underneath locking stitch such as this, going through the top, bottom, just put a lock stitch in through the back. Excess off both sides. there I have a surround bow. What you can do is add in the bow in the center.